idea. Let's go.
Welcome back to TLDR. That's right. The season hasn't even started yet, and Tyler already wants to talk playoffs. Tyler, let's hear about it.
That's right. All right. MLB opening days. This week, guys, we have baseball games that count, that matter. I hope you guys are excited about it as I am. Last week, I talked about the American League team. So this week, I'm going to go in the National League. I'm going to do this the same way I did last time. So I'm going to go division by division and kind of go from the team that's going to finish fifth all the way up to first for each division. So starting off in the NL East, the Miami Marlins in 2019, they lost 105 games. This team hasn't had a winning season since 2009. I don't think that's going to change this year either. They added some key vets to a young, talented team, like outfielders Jonathan Villar, Corey Dickerson, Matt Joyce, first baseman Jesus Aguilar, and catcher Francisco Cervelli. I think this team really needs to take a step forward to see if that franchise is moving in the direction that they want to, but they're just not going to be competitive yet this season.
Tyler, what's been their problem?
They're just rebuilding. I mean, they traded a lot of guys away.
Rebuilding?
Since
2009? Yeah, it's just bad ownership.
That's an
11-year
rebuild, bro.
Bad.
It's just ownership. Literally, you're describing the Edmonton Oilers, right?
Yeah. Yeah, it's just bad. I mean, they had guys like Christian Yelich, Marcell Ozuna on their team, and they traded all those guys away.
They also had their eighth pitcher die in a boat crash.
Which, that didn't help either.
Does not help the pitching side of things.
Yeah, so the Marlins have been going through a rough go of it the last decade or so, and hopefully, like I said, this season it'll kind of go in the right direction. But yeah, they're still not in a good spot. In fourth place, I have the Philadelphia Phillies. This is a team that has pretty high expectations, a pretty high payroll. Last year, they finished 81-81. I think this is going to be another disappointing season just because of that division. It's just really tough. They added Didi Gregorius and Zach Wheeler. They have a new manager, a new hitting coach, and a new pitching coach. So a lot of changes up front for those guys. There's a lot of question marks on the pitching side. Other than Aaron Nola, like, they just got a lot of guys that either have injury issues or are inconsistent. Guys like Jake Arrieta, Zach Eflin. These guys need to kind of step it up this year if they even want to be competitive. And the lineup also has concerns. McCutcheon's coming back from ACL. And then Rhys Hoskins, Gene Segura. These guys just need to be more consistent at the plate. Like I said, high expectations, but I think they'll fall short. In third place, had the New York Mets. They finished third last year as well. Their starting rotation headlined by back-to-back Cy Young winner Jacob DeGrom. Thor, however, is out with Tommy John, so he's not in the rotation anymore. Other than DeGrom, they got Stroman, Matz, Porcello, and Waka. Their lineup is headlined by the 2019 Rookie of the Year, Pete Alonso, Jeff Mitchell, J.D. Davis. They have Yoenis Cespedes coming back, so we'll see how effective he can be. Robinson Cano is also on the team, but he's up there with age. I think they'll battle for a wild card spot, but they just got a lot of question marks. This team has a really high ceiling. They can be really good, but just with kind of their age and the inconsistency with this team in the last few years, I just don't really trust them to grab a top spot.
How many bombs is Pete Alonso? Is he going to have in 30 games or 60 games?
Ooh. 30 game. I'm going to go. He's going to go 14.
14 and 30?
Mm-hmm.
Or 60. I keep saying 30. I don't know why, but I mean 60.
Yeah. I honestly haven't really given that a thought of like what a 60 game season and how stats are going to work. So that'll be interesting to kind of see what the benchmark is for home runs and like who finishes at the top.
Take all their stats and divide it by 14. Three. Big math numbers, guys.
Yeah, there you go. That's kind of what I tried to do in my head, but I don't know if it worked. All right, so the Washington Nationals finishing second. Obviously, these guys are the defending World Series champions. The biggest loss was Rendon signing with the Angels. But they still got a pretty good lineup. Juan Soto, Howie Kendrick, Starlin Castro, Eric Thames, Carter Kieboom is this unproven prospect that hopefully can step up and replace Rendon at third. They probably have one of the best rotations in baseball. Scherzer, Strasburg, Patrick Corbin doesn't get much better than that, than those three guys. The bullpen is a question mark, but they got Daniel Hudson and Sean Doolittle to anchor down those late innings. It's going to be a really interesting battle for the wild card in the National League. I'll get to that a little bit more later, but I think they finished second. The Atlanta Braves here, I think, are the easy favorites to win this division. Last year, they won 97 games, lost in the first round to the Cardinals. Star-starter lineup, Cunha Jr., Freddie Freeman, Ozzy Albies. They added Marcell Ozuna to their lineup. Great bullpen. Their rotation is the only kind of small concern I have for the Braves. Mike Soroka should be solid. Fulton Nevich had a really good 2018, a really subpar 2019, so we'll see if he can bounce back. If Max Fried can build his success, and if Cole Hamels will be effective at all for the Braves. So the rotation is solid, but I think their only small weakness. But with that in mind, I think that they'll definitely win the division. What do you guys think of the East?
You said they're the Braves are clear-cut winner there.
Yep.
I disagree with you. I think the Nationals will actually end up taking it, though. Even though they lost Rendon, that's pitching staff, dude. Like you said, it's elite. It doesn't get any better than those top three guys right there. For the Braves, my main concern is Freddie Freeman. He just got back, a couple days ago. He said he was fighting for his life. He was praying, God, please don't take me. 104-degree fever, he's not going to be productive in the first couple of weeks of the season. He's literally just coming back. He's not going to be the same player. So with that being said, I have the Washington Nationals at 34 games, the Mets in second with 33 games, and the Braves in third with 32 games. It's very tight for me.
It's interesting. Playing out. It's interesting you say that because Vegas has them – has according to the odds, the top four teams in the East for the National League are – It seems like it could go anywhere. It's actually the most competitive I've seen of all the leagues so thus far, with the Atlanta Braves and the Washington Nationals, over under 33.5 games, with the Mets and the Phillies trailing just behind one or two games. I mean, according to the odds, Vegas thinks that this could probably be one of the closest matchups in terms of the division. I mean, I don't know what you think, Alex.
Yeah, I have the Nationals. I agree with James. Freddie Freeman, if he's off to a slow start and has his timing off for 2 weeks, that's, each game ends up being about three games in a regular season, 2 weeks. That's a really long time to not be on top of it. I don't think Fulton Nevich bounces back. I actually just saw they had a little spring training game against the Marlins, and he gave up back-to-back-to-back homers to the Marlins, so that's not a good sign.
Oof.
Yeah, so I have the Nationals in the East. I think that three-headed monster can carry that team, just like I was talking about last week with that three-headed monster of the Rays. Pitching is going to win out, I think, in this shortened season for sure.
Yeah, obviously, we said it many times, but that 60-game season is going to be a huge wild card in all of this. But yeah, I agree. I think that division, along with the Central, is really, really tight, and it could be, honestly, any one of those three or four teams could win it. Okay, moving on to the NL Central. In last place, I got the Pittsburgh Pirates. They finished last season. This franchise is in a rough place right now. They had a really toxic year last year that featured dirty play on the field, fights within the clubhouse. Their best pitcher was charged with having sex with a minor. So they just got a lot of shit going on right now. They can't trade for shit. Guys like traded away in recent years, Garrett Cole, Tyler Glasnow, Austin Meadows, Charlie Morton, just to name a few. So this franchise from top to bottom just does not seem in a good place. Hopefully they can put it all behind them in 2020, but the Pittsburgh Pirates are going to be at the bottom. In fourth place, they got the Milwaukee Brewers. They finished second last year, made the wild card spot, and lost in the wild card game to the Nationals. 2020, they lost a few bats. They lost Travis Shaw, Yasmani Grandal, and Mike Moustakas. They did sign Christian Yelich to a 7-year deal, so they got that guy locked up for a while. However, I think they're going to take a step back for the time being until they can kind of rebuild and get some more bats in their lineup. They do still have Ryan Braun and Lorenzo Cain, but they're getting up there in age. They have really solid pitching led by Brandon Woodruff. I think this guy is going to be really, really good. Josh Hader in that bullpen. So good pitching, but just not enough hitting. In third place, the St. Louis Cardinals. They won the division last year. And they lost the NLCS to Washington. I think overall, just the depth is a concern for this team. Their pitching features Jack Flaherty, Carlos Martinez. They have a new Korean pitcher. Hopefully, I'm saying this right, Won Hyun Kim. We'll see if he can be effective at all. So that'll be an interesting arm to look for. The offense lost Ozuna the Braves. They still Paul Goldschmidt, one of the best hitters in the National League, Matt Carpenter, Dexter Fowler. But besides that, I don't think their lineup is that deep. The Cardinals have always had good young talent come up from their organization. So I think they'll probably need a couple of those guys to step up to be competitive. Like I said, just this division is too tough. I think they'll finish third. In second place, I have the Cincinnati Reds. Here comes the big red machine, you guys. This team has gone through a few losing seasons the last few years, but I think this shortened season, they're going to be really, really good. Their lineup, Eugenio Suarez, he hit 49 home runs last season. They signed Nick Castellanos, a great hitter from Detroit. He got traded to the Cubs last season. Mike Moustakas signed a 3-year deal with the Reds. Joey Votto is one of these guys that he's old vet. He had a really rough year last year, so I don't know if that's a sign of regression, but he's still a huge threat. So they just got a lot of good bats in that lineup. They're starting pitching. Luis Castillo, legit. Sonny Gray is kind of bouncing back after a few rough seasons. Trevor Bauer, weird guy, but a pretty good pitcher. And then Anthony DeSclafani showed signs of some real good pitching last season. I think he adds to that this year. So this is kind of my risky pick, kind of out there pick. But I think the Reds are going to finish second, and they're going to compete for a wild card spot. And then I have the Cubs finishing at the top. They did have a disappointing 2019, but let's not overlook them. They still have a great rotation with John Lester, Kyle Hendricks, Jose Quintana, and Yu Darvish. And their lineup has Chris Bryant, Javier Baez, Anthony Rizzo, along with Kyle Schwarber and Wilson Contreras. They have good depth. I think that they bounce back and win the 2020 division in the Central. What do you guys think?
I have the Cubs finishing fourth.
Damn.
Wow.
Yeah. I'm not a fan of the David Ross hire. I think that's weird to hire your, like, someone that was literally playing on that team literally 4 years ago. I think that's super weird, and I don't think he's going to be able to control the clubhouse. So I have the Cardinals winning, and I have the Brewers finish second, Reds, Cubs, Pirates.
It's another close one. I mean, talking one or two games, separating each other in terms of the odds. So it's could go any which direction, just like kind of like the East, I'd say, you know.
Yeah, I got the Reds.
Are you speaking or Vegas speaking?
Vegas speaking, but I'm gonna pull that out there because I'm gonna say that they know more than I do.
James, you said Reds, Brewers, Cubs.
Yep, that's my top three right there in that order. I mean, they're all separated by a game each. The 60-game season, man, like it's every game's gonna be a battle. It's gonna be ridiculous. Really fun to watch. Really excited for it.
All right, moving on to the NL West. I got the Giants finishing in last. The Bochy era is over. In comes Gabe Kapler, their new manager. I think this season is going to be like a 2020 teaser trailer for what's to come for the Giants. Buster Posey opted out, but you guys get to see Joey Bart, who's their number one prospect at catcher. So I think for Giants fans, that can be an exciting thing to look forward to. But this team.
So does that mean Buster Posey's era in San Francisco is over? Is that what that's signaling?
I mean, I think it's a sign of things to come. I mean, I'm assuming Posey is going to be back next season, but you are going to see Joey Bart, who's pretty much the future of that franchise. So I don't think it's over for Buster Posey, but you'll get to see a little bit of what's to come for this shortened season. And then the Colorado Rockies, I finished in fourth. This is the same story, different year for this team. They have a loaded lineup: Arenado, Trevor Story, Charlie Blackman, along with David Dahl, Ian Desmond, Daniel Murphy. But these guys just can't pitch. You know, blame it on Coors Field, blame it on bad pitching coaches, who knows. They just have so much inconsistency and spend way too much money on pitchers that just don't work out for them. So I think it's the same story for the Rockies, and they'll finish fourth. And third, I had the San Diego Padres. Last year, they finished last. So I think they'll take a step forward. They got a lot of good young talent. They have the best farm system in baseball. A young pitching staff, Chris Paddock, went 9-7 with a 3.33 ERA in his rookie season last year. Mackenzie Gore is the number 5 overall prospect in baseball. He might see some playing time this season, so look out for him. And their bullpen, Kirby Yates, has posted a 1.67 ERA since 2018. So they got some good pitching. Their only question is their lineup, just inconsistency. They got, you know, Manny Machado, Fernando Tatis is coming off from some injuries. Eric Hosmer is getting a little bit up there. So their lineup isn't great, but their pitching is really good. And I think they take a step forward, but finish third. In second place, they got the Diamondbacks. Again, stacked lineup for this team. Ketel Marte finished fourth in the MVP last year. Eduardo Escobar, David Peralta, Kelly, Christian Walker, Nick Ahmed. They added Starling Marte and Cole Calhoun to that lineup. Pretty solid lineup, 1-9 this year, because we got the DH. Pitching has potential to be pretty good. Zach Gallen put a 2.89 ERA in 8 starts with the team last year. Luke Weaver, Robbie Ray, and they added Madison Bumgarner to that rotation. I think they'll be a contender for the wild card, and they'll finish second. And at first place, no question here, Los Angeles Dodgers, my boys in blue. They're gonna be winning the division again. I mean, this lineup is stacked: Betts, Muncy, Turner, Bellinger, Seager, Peterson, Smith. I mean, just a lot of great lineup. Just a huge lineup. Pitching: Kershaw, Buehler, Wood, Urias. I think Stripling's gonna get that fifth spot for them. Bullpen's pretty solid. Really, the only question for this team is can they beat their postseason demons and win the World Series? Hopefully it happens. It's another year of high expectations for this team, but I definitely expect them to win that division. What do you guys think out in the West?
Yeah, I got the Dodgers.
There's no question, dude. That's pretty much all I want to say about that, is Dodgers win by a decent amount.
Yeah,
like it's no competition.
All right, and real quick, just to wrap up my wild card predictions. This is going to be like a 6-7 team race for those two wild card spots. I think that National League wild card is really competitive. This is a really, really tough decision, but I went with my gut here, and I think the Diamondbacks and the Reds are going to grab the two wild card spots.
I had Braves and Brewers, and a dog
and Gus.
That's a different dog. That's an excellent dog.
Well, right. Thank you for that, Tyler. We'll see what happens to the Dodgers once the playoffs come around. We all know what happens, but